Hey, I want to congratulate the Los Angeles Lakers, and in particular, LeBron James, for once again carrying a team on his back to the NBA Finals. He did it with the Miami Heat, first of all. He did it and won. He then turned around and did it with his beloved Cleveland Cavaliers, won. And now he's done it again with the Los Angeles Lakers, won. And each time there was skepticism because, look, LeBron did it his way. He said, and it wasn't alone. He had the team he put together that consisted of childhood friends that collectively believed they could craft a proper road for him, not just as a star, but as a responsible member of the United States and world community. And they are to be applauded for what they have done. He comes at a time when we do need athletes as leaders. Some of you may not like his position. I question why you would not, but I say he is to be applauded for walking his talk. And most important for this, he came back, and I have to freeze this because I'm looking at these images of Kobe Bryant, and in this case with AD Anthony Davis, you've got to really remember Kobe and his impact on the Lakers and the sports world and basketball world and pop culture, and his great contributions to basketball and the LA community as well. And the tragic way that he died should never have happened. It should not have. So for this to happen, for the Lakers to at least go through the adversity of the coronavirus to an unknown environment in the bubble in Orlando, not even their own home, and to play as well as they did, although at times questionably dirty, I have to say that, all right? But more often than not, brilliant. Look, to do it, captured in Game 6 as they did, under these circumstances, is to be commended beyond measure. Beyond measure. So, sports and the NBA trophy have returned to Los Angeles. And the Lakers matter now. They are the champions until somebody knocks them off. Doesn't matter the season. You can't put an asterisk by this because the NBA did everything it could to make this environment work. You didn't hear a lot of reports of teams having way too many players and having to shift around their schedules because of the way the NBA did it. They did it a smart way. They did it the right way. They were determined to make it work. They did not shy away from Black Lives Matter. They embraced Black Lives Matter and made it a brand. And they've really grabbed the nation and put the nation on its collective back, the NBA did. And I think what the NBA has done is remarkable, particularly with respect to Black Lives Matter. Every time I see those t-shirts and jerseys that they wear, they say Black Lives Matter, I smile. So they are to be commended as well. And congratulations personally to my friend Jason Kidd, who I thought was going to be head coach of the Lakers. I remember he was headed to Scottsdale in a conversation. But the Cal great got the next best thing. He was assistant. Now he's part of history. Once again, part of a winning organization in the Los Angeles Lakers. The Lakers clobbered a Heat team that was brilliant at points and streaky at others. Always were driven by Jimmy Butler. And played an excellent series, save for the final game. It's like they almost just said, here, take it, you know? They went out in a way that I think they would like to have back. I really do. But when all is said and done, this was the Lakers' year. It started out being the Lakers' year. It ended being the Lakers' year. The Lakers are the 2020 NBA champions. And I can't wait till the Warriors come back whole, even though they're in San Francisco. So I'm going to go and watch the rest of this, but subscribe to Zinni62 and bookmark OaklandNewsNow.com. Look at them celebrating with the trophy there. See? So it's going to be interesting. I'll see you.